Thank you so much, and good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Schneebeck Concert Hall, whether you're here in person or you're watching on the live stream. We want to welcome you to the first concert of the school year for our wind ensemble. The musicians you see seated in front of you come from just about every major on campus. Some of them are actually music majors, minors, or none, but they're all very committed and dedicated to this art form of creating art through band music. And so we're really excited to present our concert to you. We're going to get things kicked off here with an overture titled Overture in 5 Flat. Now, for some of you who are music people out there, it's not 5 flats, but it's more of a reference to you have 5 minutes to perform this music. And this is a tongue-in-cheek joke from Julie Giroux, who's the composer of this piece. And what it does is it captures that raw power of the wind ensemble, but also like sheer energy through speed. So we hope you enjoy Overture in 5 Flat. Time to buckle up.
Thank you.
That's just fun, right? Yeah, so we want to thank Julie Giroux for that one. She's a very prolific living composer who writes a lot of really amazing music. So it was really fun to engage that. So my heart rate's going right now, so I have to catch my breath. Next up on the program, though, is a piece by Eric Whitaker, who's also a living composer. Eric has written a lot of choral music and also has written for basically every medium. His band music is really, really gorgeous. This one is titled October, and as you might imagine, Eric was trying to capture the spirit of the fall, the autumn season. And in it, it's the changing of the season, the cooler air, the falling leaves, the shorter daylight that we have. And he finds a sentimentality in the season. He says it's one of his favorites. And these are original melodies in this piece by Eric, but he drew from his inspiration from the romantic composers of romanticism, such as like Ray Vaughan Williams and Elgar, specifically Ray Vaughan Williams, and which is, you'll hear one of Vaughan Williams' pieces to conclude our program tonight. But he draws from Vaughan Williams the kind of lyric nature and quality of the melodic line. So we hope you enjoy Eric's October. Thank you. So hopefully you are envisioning the crisp air and the falling beautiful leaves that Eric has evoked in that in his piece. Next up on the program is Percy Grainger. At the beginning of the semester, when we all came together for the first time as a newly formed wind ensemble for the school year, with all of our new musicians and returning musicians, I talked to them about pieces they want to perform. And actually, October came from within the ensemble. One of the musicians, it was Maya, who actually said, "Hey, can we play October?" And I said, "Of course we can. That's a great piece for us to be performing." But as we were going, we sit in a circle and we give our name, our pronouns, our major, minor, all the things that we want to know, something fun we did over the summer. One of the members, Mia Stenberg, had said, "You know, hey, I'm Mia." She's like, "The clarinet section is stacked this year." And I was like, and I totally agree. So with that, I took that as an inspiration to feature our clarinet section on this next piece. So this is an Irish reel titled Molly on the Shore. And so in Granger's setting here, it features our clarinet section. And it's just a really, really fun tune. So we hope you enjoy Molly on the Shore.
Thank you.
I mean, who doesn't agree with Mia now? Like, they're stacked, right? That's quite a great clarinet section there. Beautiful work, you guys, to all of you. Really lovely job there. Okay, moving on now. The next piece on the program is actually the title of the concert, and that's Lasting Light. And this piece is written by Viet Quang, is a dear friend of mine, and who just raised gorgeous music. He was actually on campus just a couple of years ago where we premiered a piece for the CBDNA division conference that we hosted right here. And this piece was inspired by a trip to the Grand Canyon. And Viet was sitting on the rim of the canyon and enjoying a sunset. And so his inspiration here is the changing colors of the sky and the vastness of the canyon and the grandeur of and beauty of the nature and the expanse of sky behind it. And as I said, the changing colors of the sky. So I really love this piece of music. And so the students had an idea to contribute to the piece. We have a video slideshow that's going to accompany it. And these are all photos that were submitted by members of the ensemble and then curated by Ray. Ray, can you stand up and take a little bow here? So Ray took all of the photos and curated them into this little slideshow to just accompany the music as part of the inspiration. So here is Viet Quang's Lasting Light. Thank you. All right, so we have one more piece for you to conclude the program. This is the Ray Vaughan Williams. On the score and in the profession, it's titled The English Folk Song Suite. And it's because Ray Vaughan Williams is from England, and it's because the folk tunes that are contained within this suite of three movements come from the English countryside. However, technically, the formal title is just Folk Song Suite. So I mentioned this just in case there's any. I know my colleague Gwen Brown is in the audience. She's a musicologist who knows everything, and so I want her to be proud of me that I'm actually getting this right. So I hope you're proud of me, Gwen. but this is a really delightful piece, as I mentioned, in three movements, all English folk songs, and the folk songs that deal with life, right? That's what folk songs are about. They're about joy, and they're about pain. They're about loss, and about everything, right? About our human emotions. And so this piece is jam-packed with a lot of that. And we have had a lot of fun working on this piece. And so before we perform it, I just have a few thank yous really quick. First, I want to thank all of you for being here tonight, whether you're here in person or on the web. It means a lot to us that you support us. I want to also thank our director of the School of Music, Dr. Tracy Doyle, for all of her support of the wind band medium and for the support she gives us, which is ongoing. So thank you so much to all of you. I would also like to thank my mom for tuning in Michigan. Hey, Mom, I love you and I miss you. I hope you like my mustache. Yes, she's paying attention. And I have one shameless plug for you. Okay, so tomorrow night is another concert downtown. This is of the Tacoma Concert Band, of which I am the conductor and artistic director, and we have a Halloween show planned for tomorrow night. And I mention it because two of our students on stage, Levi and Skyler, are both performing with the Tacoma Concert Band as part of experiential learning. Yep, doing an amazing job. Levi has a really big E-flat clarinet solo in the dance Dream of the Witch's Sabbath from Symphony Fantastique. So if you want to hear some really wicked E-flat clarinet playing, you want to be there tomorrow night. And Skyler is he's the chime player or the bell player in the same piece. And they're both doing a bang-up job. In addition, our director, Tracy Doyle, is playing in the flute section. So there's four of us from the university that are involved that are currently here. At any rate, I mention this because I have 10 more comp tickets to give away. And so if you're interested in coming to this concert tomorrow night, 7:30 p.m., Pantages Theater, downtown Tacoma, meet me by the stage door, first come, first serve, and you can have a free ticket to the concert. I just want to make sure that I give all of these away. Last but not least, I want to thank the students that are sitting on the stage for their dedication. Yeah. For their dedication, the time, the energy, the effort they put into creating art, right? It's fun to perform well, but as we all know, it's a discipline, and it takes time and energy. And a lot of a musician's time is spent alone in a practice room, learning, woodshedding, and preparing for performances like you're experiencing tonight, which is really exhilarating. So I just want to reiterate how much I love all of you, and I'm so grateful for all of you. So thank you. Okay, now for a little Vaughan Williams. Thank you.
Thank you.